today we have this teeny tiny little beehive. You know, before I do what I'm about to do, I should take a thermal image shot of this so you can see, but I'm not gonna do it. But if I did, you would see the cluster probably like right here in the bottom of the box. Maybe over here, maybe back there, but somewhere around here. Not a big cluster, but hopefully big enough. There's four frames of bees down there, and they are clustered down there. And that's a medium box. It's a deep box. Below the medium frames is nothing but a hard insulation, so it's got a nice insulated bottom. And this is a medium box right here, and it's four frames of capped honey, and that's their food. And the bees are down here, and they have some food down there too. And hello, that was a blue jay. And this is a piece of hard insulation. It's a cover. It's sealed in or sealed down with silicone, and you can see all the cracks here are sealed down with silicone as well. So in other words, this little tiny beehive is it's got insulation up top and bottom. What is going on? Either they're up to something. They're alarmed about something. Either there's a food source or there's something walking around the area, like a fox or a cat. Anyway, so they're gonna serenade me, I guess, for the rest of this video. And so this hive has insulation up top, insulation on the bottom, and it doesn't have anything on the side, and it's getting cold. And I could have put, and probably should have put, insulation on the sides or some sort of wrap on earlier, but I didn't. Small colonies could use all the help they can get. That's my basic motto, if you want to boil it down to a motto. And large colonies that are at least three mediums full of bees and honey, just packed like large clusters, they don't need as much help. They've got tons of food. This is four frames of honey. They're solid for food, but they don't have insulation. And they're still clustering down low, which is good. This is the only hole that they have. I got this thing on it. I don't know what this thing is called. And I could do it like, turn this on like this. Whoops. And this will supposed to allow bees to get out, but honestly, that seems pretty thin to me. And then there's this slit. It's a little bit thicker, and I think they can get through that. They can kind of squeeze through that. And then there's the whole thing like that. And I think what I'll do is just like do it like this, not even have the whole hole open, just do it like this kind of thing. Like right about there. Right, so a bee can easily pass through that. And I don't think a shrew would have a hard time getting in there. Like a slug could get into, but anyway, whatever. So what I'm doing today, it's freezing. It's not windy, but it's freezing. I'm taking this hard insulation, and I'm gonna cut it up. I couldn't find my sharp knife, so I've just got my pocket knife. I'm gonna cut it up into pieces, and I'm gonna tape it on with some tuck tape, and I'm just gonna wrap it up with insulation. The insulation that I have is, it's 2 inches thick, it's R10, but I think that means that for every inch of this insulation, you get an R10 value, so maybe this is an R20 all total. I'm probably wrong. I've never really got my head around how that R system works, but I thought it was for every inch of insulation, you've got whatever the R value is. So, but maybe the R value is 10 for the whole 2 inches. I don't know. But 10 is good enough. For the sides of the hive, I think it doesn't have to be massive. It just, like, the top, really the top of the hive is where it needs as much insulation as you can put on it. R20, 30, 40, go nuts. But for the sides, as long as they've got a little bit of insulation, it should be fine. At least in my climate, here in Flat Rock. So, yeah, so this is what I'm doing. I'm gonna just try to, I should have measured this already, and I could have just had it all pre-cut. I could have used my table saw to cut this. We're just gonna do it the hard way and cut it with a pocket knife. So I just put the insulation up against the side of the hive like that, and then I etched in the outline of the hive. onto the insulation. And now we're gonna cut it. Let's just see if it snaps off. Here we go. Yep, nice. It's convenient having this little doodad on the hive so that if I do anything to alarm the bees, I can just close it up like this. They can still breathe, but they can't get out and sting me. Something I don't like about wrapping or putting insulation on the sides of my hives is that there's always a chance that moisture of some sort, condensation or rain or whatever, will get between the insulation, the wrap, and the hive. Moisture will get in, seep in, and get stuck in there. It'll stay inside in that crevice or in the little tiny, teeny tiny space between the wrap and the hive, and it'll hold moisture to the hive, into the wood. It'll seep in through the cracks. If there's a propolis seal between the supers, it can dissolve the propolis seal, and that's the one thing I don't like. But what are you gonna do? So I am putting tuck tape around every little crack, just hoping for the best there. I was just sitting here cutting the insulation, and what the hell happened? How did this happen? Below, there's these little holes. In the insulation. Where'd that come from? And how did it happen? Like, wouldn't I have just seen this when I was cutting it before? What the hell is that? Okay, something happened there where my knife cutting through somehow created these little holes on the other side of them. Oh well, someone explain the physics of that to me, please, because what the hell? That's interesting. Whew, all right, we're getting there, and it's getting colder. I'm getting very cold. So, this thing is pretty wrapped. It's got so thick insulation and hard insulation on the side, hard insulation on this side, hard insulation up top, hard insulation on the bottom, and in between, in the middle here, we've got four frames of honey and four frames of honey and bees. If I left it like this, it might work out fine, because what we have is a heat source down in the bottom of the hive, which are the bees. They're breathing, giving off condensation. Condensation rises to the top. This is a warm surface, this is a warm surface. These are all warm surfaces, but this would be cold. There's a differential in temperature, basically, right? So the warm moisture wants to go where it's cold. So it's gonna go up, hit all these warm spots, and then move to this cold surface, which is the front of the hive. It'll condense on the hive and then pour down in front of the hive and not on the bees. The only problem with this system is that this is the only ventilation that the bees have in the entire hive. It's right smack in the middle of the hive. It's not in the bottom, it's not in the top, it's right in the middle. So any condensation that drips down, it's going to drip right down to the bottom of the hive and possibly stay in the bottom of the hive. So the bottom might get a little bit wet. I don't know. We're going to find out. I could insulate the back as well so that the only cold part in the hive will be the front. And so anything that's any warm, moist air that the bees are producing will go out that hole. Will that work? I don't know. Okie dokie, we're done. This is what it looks like. This is my owl. That's Ernie, in honor of Ernie Coombs, Mr. Dress-Up. And so, this is what I did. I just took some leftover pieces of insulation that I'd cut off of that thing, and I just taped it to the back end of that and completely covered the back of the hive. So the back of the little hive is covered. The top is covered, already had insulation. Sides are covered. Everything's covered up and down everywhere around except for the front of the hive, except for this little section right here. That's the only part that doesn't have insulation. So good enough. It's getting cold and windy, but there we go. Anyway, it looks ridiculous, but it should hold up. I'm curious to see how this is going to play out, because I would rather it had a bottom entrance. Hopefully I don't end up with a big pool of water at the end of this winter, full of dead bees at the bottom too, getting moldy and stuff. I could see that happening, but we'll see. Anyway, I have to put some wrap and some insulation around a few other smaller colonies. Well, I have one other colony that's pretty small that needs a bit of wrap, and that ain't happening today because my fingers are beginning to freeze. So this mess is my other collection of small colonies, but are much better shape than the one we were just looking at. That's the 3 5-frame, 3-story nukes, all smacked together for holding the heat together, to share their heat. And they've got insulation up top. I'll show you. Big fat insulation up there. And they've got all kinds of weird insulation all around. And you can see already that these holes right here, this happened today. These are northern flickers probably pecking at it. So I've got to, I have to paint them some funky color, or I'm gonna wrap them in silver bubble wrap, something just to keep the northern flickers away. I painted them, my hives, a funky color, unnatural colors to deter the northern flickers, but then I had to put the insulation on and the insulation wasn't funky enough for them, and now they're pecking at that. Chickens apparently love this stuff too, so. Yeah, that's the next step. Anyway, it's a mess, but I have high hopes for these bees, for sure. Anyway, I gotta clean up all this junk, and hopefully the feeling in my hands will return shortly.